We all know the biblical tale of Moses upon the fiery mountain. The one about the cities of the plain destroyed in a fiery hailstorm whose description could refer to a volcanic eruption. The fact that many biblical texts clearly refer to volcanic activity has been well known to historians for a long time. The word Zion is widely known. Theologians interpret it as pillar. Identifying Zion as Sinai and Horeb is common in both theology and Bible studies. Hieronymus in particular noted that, it appears that the same mountain is called by two different names, Sinai and Horeb. The believers believe everything the Bible tells them without questioning. Whereas the vehement atheists renounce everything the book has to say is nonsense, absurdity and malignant spells used for enslaving the people and keeping it obedient and ignorant. The rational person shall however try to think of what the ancient author could really be referring to. Volcanoes? But there aren't any active volcanoes anywhere in the Middle East, nor Northern Africa, nor most of continental Europe, for that matter. However, there is an exception, Italy and the famous Vesuvius. It is at a considerable distance from Palestine, granted. But let us sit down for a second, draw our breath and make the heretical presumption that the real events that became reflected in the book we know as the Bible really took place elsewhere. Despite of what the illustrations in the modern Bibles are telling us.
This book will change your entire perception of history forever. What if ancient Rome, Greece, and Egypt were invented during the Renaissance? What if the Old Testament was a rendition of events in the Middle Ages? What if Jesus Christ was born in 1053 and crucified in 1086 AD? Sounds unbelievable? Not after you've read History, Fiction or Science by Anatoly Fomenko, the leading mathematician of our time.
The consensual history insists that all the events concerning the biblical patriarchs occurred precisely and exclusively on the territory of the modern Mesopotamia and Syria. Nevertheless, it is immediately acknowledged that as to what concerns the identity of the patriarchs Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, one can just reiterate that the information obtained as a result of the most fruitful excavations in Syria and Mesopotamia was extremely meager, or simply non-existent. One might wonder just how justifiable it is to search for traces of the biblical patriarchs in modern Mesopotamia. Archaeology as well as historical science in general can find no proof to the biblical legend about the Egyptian slavery of the Jews. The Egyptologist Wilhelm Spielberg tells us that what the Bible reports about the plight of Israel in Egypt isn't any more of a historical fact than the accounts of Egyptian history related by Herodotus. Anyway, it is clear that the research concerning the pharaoh under whose rule Israel moved into Egypt and left it represents nothing but the juggling of names and dates void of all meaning. Could an altogether different country be described by the name of Egypt?
This book will change your entire perception of history forever. What if ancient Rome, Greece, and Egypt were invented during the Renaissance? What if the Old Testament was a rendition of events in the Middle Ages? What if Jesus Christ was born in 1053 and crucified in 1086 AD? Sounds unbelievable? Not after you've read History, Fiction or Science by Anatoly Fomenko, the leading mathematician of our time.